Thank you very much. First, our message is on behalf of all of the people in the state of New York, we bring you heartfelt love and concern. We've obviously been watching on TV what you've been going through. Frankly, the reality of it is much worse than has been portrayed by the media. But everyone in New York is concerned, and that's one of the reasons I'm here today. I want to thank the governor for inviting me down, but we know these are difficult times, and you're in our thoughts and in our prayers. The media communication of it, I can tell you as someone sitting in New York, did not communicate the extent of the damage that has been done. It is much, much worse than I think the damage that was done to the mainland United States. We've seen buildings where two of the four walls were literally blown out with it. 160 mile per hour wind came right through the building and just emptied everything out of it. Rooftops that are gone, an entire power system, above ground power system, knocked down, poles broken like twigs all over the island. It really is pervasive, it really is devastating. I want to applaud the governor and his team for how they have responded. And as quickly as they've responded, the shelter operation, getting out food and water to people, organizing emergency operations, it's been done extraordinarily well. As I told the governor, I've dealt with emergencies in the state of New York as governor. Before that, I was in the federal government. I was Secretary of Housing and Urban Development, and I worked on disaster situations all over the globe. And I've seen it done right, and I've seen it done wrong. And everything the governor is doing is exactly right, in my opinion, so I applaud him for that. It's not going to be a short road. I wish I could say, you know, in a few weeks, a few months, it's all going to be better. The truth is, this is going to be a long road to rebuild. That's the fact. The good news is, seeing the damage, to lose one life is one too many, but that there weren't more fatalities is frankly shocking to me when you see the level of damage. So we thank the good Lord for that. And the good news on the reconstruction is that the goal here, as the governor describes it, is not going to be to just rebuild, but to rebuild better than before. And how do you take this terrible situation and lemonade out of lemons, make it a positive at the end of the day, and use the funds that are going to come in to build a community that's even better and stronger than before. And I believe the governor and his team are going to do exactly that. However New York can help, we will help. The governor spent some time in New York. I said, once you're part of the New York family, you're always part of the New York family. But the connection between the USVI and New Yorkers is very, very strong. I can't tell you how many people I met on the street who said right away, I just visited New York, I'm from New York, I have family in New York. So there's a very strong connection, and it's a relationship that we value and we respect. Everyone was gracious, and it's amazing how positive their spirits are. There'll be frustrating days ahead. As I said, it's not going to be fast. It's not going to be easy. But I felt a real strength and a real sense of resilience in people. They've been through something like this before, and I think it's going to be just fine. We're going to start helping right away. I'm going to get back this evening. We're going to deploy a team that's designed to help with what we've seen. But we'll be sending another 100 National Guard. We'll be sending 30 New York State troopers to come down right away with Humvees, with a fuel truck, with a gator to get to places that are hard to get access to. So we're starting right away, but I told the governor this is a long road and we will be there through every step of the way. There's a lot of government agencies to deal with, a lot of bureaucracy to deal with. New York has more than our share of experience dealing with that, so however we can help, we are there. I also believe that in many ways when things are at their worst is when people are at their best. And I felt that today. You feel the goodness of people come out, people helping in shelters, people volunteering, even though they have their own problems. You know, the resilience and the beauty of the human spirit, I felt, and it was an inspiration to me. So, Governor, congratulations on the way you and your team have handled it. We're sorry for what you're going through. It will be a long road, but the light at the end of the tunnel is you're going to build back better. I have no doubt. And any way we can help, we will.
Thank you. Thank you, Governor.
Thank you, my friend.
Thank you so much. I really, really appreciate it.